Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Universal Studios Florida and a very special holiday presentation. Their records have sold more than 32 million copies. They are the number one selling Christmas artist of all time. Universal Orlando Resort, in partnership with American Gramophone, proudly presents The Christmas Music of Mannheim Steamroller by Chip Davis. ladies and gentlemen, Grammy award-winning composer, Chip Davis.
Wow, thank you all very much. Say, I sure appreciate you all being here tonight. You're what makes this Steamroller steam and roll, and we keep coming back, and I hope we'll be coming back some more. This is our 10th year of doing this concert series. So I thought I might take a minute and introduce our players. Of course, our fabulous Universal Orchestra. On my left, keyboard player is Jonathan Svoboda, longtime veteran of Mannheim Steamroller. And on my right is Carly Daniels. She wanted to change the name of the Steamroller to the Carly Daniels Band, but there's a band that has a name that kind of sounds like that. I don't want to get in trouble. Those drummers, wow. Anyway, the last thing I wanted to mention before we get on with the concert is that, you know, Mannheim is typically an instrumental band. We're instrumental in a lot of different things. But there's a girl who is so cute and a really, really good singer that I had to write an arrangement for her. I chose Greensleeves to do in a little different way than normally you hear Greensleeves. And she's just such a good singer, but she's mostly just so darn cute. You know, the odd thing, it turns out she's my 14-year-old daughter. You'll see her on the side screen. So her name is Elise Marie Davis. So off we go with Greensleeves.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, once again, Chip Davis.
Thank you. This is where I tell the story about how we got doing this. You ever been to Harry Potter's wand shop? Well, I used to be a frog. And I was hopping around one day, hippity hop, not the bunny hop, just a frog hop. And someone came out with one of these magic wands and turned me into a conductor. You know how you get a conductor? Take one stick away from a drummer. I know. They get better, but not tonight. Anyway, I was very fortunate, and I had a number of good friends here working at Universal, and wanted to start off with this Grinch concert, and then the thing started in one another part of the park, which it still runs in. And then now we have the concerts running. Like I say, we've been doing this for 10 years now, and hopefully we'll be back some more. And I'll leave you alone, quit telling you bad jokes. Well, maybe not. Thank you, I guess.
And now, please welcome the talented performers of Universal Orlando's Grinchmas.
Stole Christmas. Inside a snowflake, like the one on your sleeve, there happened a story you must see to believe. Way up in the mountains, in the high range of Pontoos, lay the small town of Whoville, the home of the Whos.
Christmas, Christmas, Christmas Day.
Decorations were being hung by the windows with care in the hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. Working through the night and all through the day was the decorating committee, led by the lovely Martha May. Little Cindy Lou had questions in her tiny hoo heart about the Grinch and Christmas. Where did it all start? Then the Grinch got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. The Grinch laughed in his throat, and he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat, and he chuckled and clucked.
What a great Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I'll look just like Saint Nick. I'm speaking in rhyme. Splash. You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black
He was grinchishly humming.
They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming.
Then the Grinch heard a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. But the sound wasn't sad. Why, this sound sounded merry. And he puzzled and puzzled till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before.
Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say, that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.
Welcome, Christmas. Bring your cheer. Cheer to all who's far and near.
Christmas Day is in our grasp, as long as we have hands to clasp.
Christmas Day will always be, just as long as we have we.
Welcome Christmas, while we stand, heart to heart and hand to hand.
Davis and the music of Mannheim Steamrollers.